for us the path to eternity. Grant, we pray, that we may keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection, and may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up to the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Thank you. sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life appears,
and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we do not know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In June of 1971, I became a graduate of the August Institution of Cathedral Parish School on St. George Street. After Mass here in the morning, after which we received our diplomas, the graduates headed to Eddie's Caravan Restaurant, located out on Ponce de Leon Boulevard. There we had a breakfast with our sisters, St. Joseph, our parents, our classmates. At each of our places, the graduates had gifts from the faculty at CPS. All of us had a plaque of some kind. As I remember, all the boys who graduated got the plaque that said, "This is the first day of the rest of your life." I thought to myself, this day, this is what starts my life? What happened to all the other days? I wasn't impressed with eighth grade graduation, to be very honest with you, because I knew in a matter of months I was no longer going to be on the top of the so-called mountain, because I would be walking one block to the north as a freshman into St. Joseph Academy, and the thought of that caused me to tremble. If this was the first day of the rest of my life, I wasn't sure what the future really held. The scriptures today have told us about another day. In the 118th Psalm, "This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad." When we hear that term day, we almost always think of a period of 24 hours that is marked by a piece of time that marks out seconds and minutes and hours. But the day which is spoken of here in this psalm is not a day to be measured in time. Rather, it is a day for eternity. It is an eternal day, a day in which there will be no more darkness, only light. How do we know? Because another verse of this psalm tells us, "God's mercy endures forever." This forever day allows us to live in the awesome mercy and power of God. The power of God to overcome all darkness, the power and might of God to overcome even death itself. This day, our Lord Jesus Christ lives forever at the right hand of his heavenly Father, his Father who has glorified him, the Father who through Christ and the gift of the Holy Spirit wants us too to come to share as well. An eternal day, a day in which nothing that is difficult, nothing that causes us turmoil, nothing that causes trial or tribulation will be able to ever again affect us. The church looks longingly for that day as it celebrates not only this feast of Christ's resurrection, but also in the 50 days that will now lead us to the celebration of Pentecost, the outpouring of the gift of God to remain with his church for all human time. That gift of the Spirit is the promised gift that we will one day know that eternal day, that we will one day know that time when no more darkness, no more pain, no more death will ever be able to overtake us. This is why we know that resurrection is different than resuscitation. When someone is resuscitated after they have potentially or actually died, we know that human death will still eventually overtake them. But with risen life, with the life of the risen Christ, with resurrection, we are granted an eternal day. An eternal day that is not measured by seconds or minutes or hours, or even days, weeks, months, years, decades, centuries, eras, and eons. We are given something by God because we are given a mercy that endures forever. The promise of that eternal day is bestowed upon the church once more. The question then that we as people of faith must ask is, can each day of my human life point to that eternal day? Can my belief in Christ's victory over sin and death inspire me, my family, my church family, the human family, to live as if that eternal day was already a reality? It won't be perfect because it has not yet been fulfilled. And yet, the Lord, through the gift of the Spirit, allows us to touch, even in some kind of small and minimal way, the gift that eternal day. Today's psalm has also given us another image, an image of a stone rejected by the builders that has become the cornerstone. The early Christians would see in this image the person of Christ himself. They would realize that they would have to build their lives on the cornerstone of Christ, crucified, buried, and risen. Can we do the same? Even in these difficult times that many are experiencing because of the coronavirus, we have to allow Jesus to be the cornerstone of our life now, our life in eternity. The psalmist has proclaimed the great wonders that God has done for his Son Jesus Christ, and that that day of eternity has dawned in the resurrection. Today we are given the new gift of hope to know that we possess it already, and that by our faithful living of the life of Christ, we will possess it with Christ in eternity. Using the creed of our baptism, the Apostles' Creed, we profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. This is the day the Lord has made, and we rejoice in the resurrection of Christ from the dead. We turn now in prayer to God, the Father of Jesus, that all people may share his blessings.
For the Church, that in this time of darkness and doubt, we may radiate the light of Christ each day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace and justice in all the human family, that God will bring a springtime of faith and new life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in need, the poor and the hungry, the sick and their caregivers, may Christ, who burst the bonds of death, be their hope and healing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all confined to their homes, may God protect them, renew their spirits, and give them peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who await the Easter sacraments of baptism, confirmation, and Eucharist, that God will strengthen their resolve to follow his Son, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they rejoice in the reward of everlasting life won by Christ's victory of death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In the beauty of this Easter day, your people lift up a sacrifice of praise to you, O God. Hear our prayer and ready our hearts to celebrate this festival in spirit and in truth. For Christ, our Passover sacrifice, has been raised from the dead and intercedes for us always at your right hand. He lives and reigns forever. Pray, brothers and sisters, that this, my sacrifice and yours, will be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all the Holy Church.
Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your Church is wondrously reborn and nourished. through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Amen. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Augustine and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Felipe, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the risen Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
On behalf of my brother priest, I want to take this opportunity to wish to all of the parishioners of the Cathedral Parish, as well as those who are watching our live stream, a very, very blessed and happy Easter day. Please know that the cathedral will be open to you for private prayer from 10 a.m. to 3 o'clock this afternoon. I hope that you will come by and spend a few moments reflecting on the wondrous mystery of Christ risen from the dead. You can also see the
efforts of our resident florist and handyman. And with all of that, Father Jeff, many of you have commented it is great to see him back with us. It is, but you can certainly see his hand at work in the decorations that he has done for us for this great season now of Easter. One announcement concerning tomorrow, Easter Monday. It is a day off for the members of our staff at the cathedral, so the cathedral will not be open on Monday, but will again be open for the regular hours of 10 to 3 beginning Tuesday. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
And may he who restores you to eternal life and the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's passion have drawn to a close, may you celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast, come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty